Hey everyone, welcome back to Small Batch Devs. My name is Austin.
And I'm Elliot. Today we're going over a good user experience design principle known as confirm delete dialogues.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. It would definitely help us out. But without any further ado, let's jump into it.
So what exactly is a confirm delete dialogue?
So a confirm delete dialogue message is a message that you present to your users just to let them know that they're about to perform a destructive action.
Yeah, and these messages are usually accompanied by some sort of confirmation button that the user has to click in order to complete their original task.
So why would we want to use these dialogues?
Well, you'd want to use a confirm delete dialogue so that you can prevent accidental deletions on behalf of your user.
So let's say that your user accidentally hits a delete button in your app and there's no confirmation presented to them. Then their data would just be gone. And this actually happens sometimes, and it could be very frustrating for your user, and they'll probably not want to use your software if they could run into this mistake.
Confirm delete dialogues are actually pretty simple to include in your application, and we're going to cover a few different examples of ways you can implement them. So the first example you see is actually our confirm dialogue in our blog website. And this is the dialogue that we use when one of the administrators tries to delete a blog post. It pops up this alert dialogue that's very basic, just has a simple yes or no confirmation.
A better and more secure example, like this one here, forces you to actually type in a command or some sort of message so that you can't just accidentally click delete and then accidentally again click OK or something. You actually have to provide a little more complex of information to actually delete the whatever you're trying to delete.
So the last example here is actually taken from AWS. And this example is great because it shows not only is the user trying to delete something, not only do they have to type in some sort of message, but they have to type in the name of the item that's being deleted. And this is great because there's no doubt in the user's mind that they're deleting something, but they know exactly what piece of data they're deleting based on the name that they have to type in.
So the only caveat to deleting data in this sort of format is that if you need to delete many pieces of data at once, that can be obviously pretty tricky because we have to run through the same confirmation over and over again. So you'll need to figure out a way of providing a batch deletion if that is something your app needs. And that will obviously may or may not include this sort of complex confirmation, if you will.
So today we covered a pretty simple user experience design tip known as the confirm delete dialogues. We gave you a couple different examples, and we hope you incorporate these in your applications in the future.
If you learned something or if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and of course hit the notification bell, and also check out our small batch devs.com blog site where we convert these YouTube videos into a blog format. You can also check us out on social media that includes Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook at Small Batch Devs. We really appreciate you watching this video and we'll see you next time.
Peace.